Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchaudhary, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I'll demonstrate how you can access different parts of the message assembly when using JSON mapping with Discovery Connector nodes. The enhancements were added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.10. So for this demonstration, I'm sending a JSON message over HTTP to a message flow. The JSON message has details that's needed for creating an issue in GitHub. So I'm going to provide a title, a description, and a label. A GitHub request node will be used to create the GitHub issue, and it's going to use the details in that input message. And then a Slack request node will be used to send a message to Slack, and that's going to use some details from the output message from the GitHub request node. So it's going to use the issue number, and it's going to use some flow details as well. So it's going to specify the application name and flow name in the message that is sent to Slack. So I'm going to demonstrate how to access parts of the input root tree that's going to be used by the GitHub request node. And the Slack request node is going to use a schema which describes the output message from the GitHub request node, and it'll be using the flow details as well. I'm going to create this from scratch so that you can follow along and create the flow yourself. So let's create an application. So I'll call it Create Issue App. And let's create a flow. Let's call it Create Issue. And let's start with an HTTP input node and an HTTP reply node. And let's configure the HTTP input node so that it has a path suffix. So let's call it create issue and ensure the domain is JSON. So let's add a GitHub request node so that an issue can be created in a GitHub repo. And let's add a Slack request node so that a message can be sent to Slack. So new in version 12.0.10, the request tab for a Discovery Connector node has a map inputs table. And the map inputs table describes different entries which can be used for doing some JSON mapping on the node. So you can specify the message that's sent to the backend connector when sending the message to it for using it to describe the event that's being used by the connector. So by default, it has two entries. It has an input root, an input local environment, and you can add further map input entries as well. But for the GitHub input request node, I'm just going to be accessing the parts of the input root. I'm going to launch the Connect Discovery Wizard. I already have a GitHub policy project with the details of the account, and I have the credentials already in the vault. You can see previous videos on how to do that configuration for the Discovery Connector nodes. So the Connect Discovery Wizard has been launched, and I'm going to select the action to create an issue. And I need to specify my organization and my repo. There is a new controls section in the Connected Discovery Wizard, and there is an option on how you describe the message. So you can either define the mappings below, which is the default option, or you can specify to use the input message unchanged. So I want to specify where to get fields which describes the message that's going to be needed so that the GitHub connector can create the issue. I can click on this icon here and specify that I'm going to be using the input root, and inside the input root I'm going to be accessing part of the JSON message. So I need to specify JSON domain dot data. There is a root element called issue, and under there is a field called title. So that is all that's needed for the title. I'm going to do the same for description. So select input root, click on edit expression, and specify .json.data.issue.description. And for the label, I need to specify that it is in input root.json.data.issue.label, and this needs to be as a JSON array. Okay, so I've specified my fields that are needed for the issue that's going to be created in GitHub. So I can save this and close the connected discovery wizard for the GitHub request node. And now I'm going to configure my Slack request node. So for my Slack request node, I want to access the output message that comes out of the GitHub request node. So the GitHub request node has a schema which describes the output message, and you can see that it has the issue number in the output message. So if on my Slack request node, I go to the request tab and I add an entry to the map inputs table, and I specify that I want to use the GitHub request node. So it's automatically found this because it's wired already. So it's intelligent and finds the GitHub request node. It's found the schema as well, so I don't need to browse for it. I can click OK, and it's added the entry in the map inputs table. So what this allows me to do is to specify in the connected discovery wizard the location of the issue number. I already have a Slack policy project, so I'm going to select that, and that's using the account, and I have the credentials in my vault already. So I'm going to launch the connected discovery wizard, and I'm going to specify that I want to send a message, and it's going to be sent to a channel, and the channel name is done with a new Nathan Ace. And now I can specify the contents of the message. So I will say new issue. And then I'll specify the issue number. So I can click on this icon here. This is the entry that I've added for the GitHub request node. And under there, I can access the issue number. I can put a new issue, and then issue number has been created in GitHub. I'll put some of the flow details. I can put from message flow, and now if I click on the icon again, I can open up flow details. I can specify the application name, and I can also specify the flow name. So this is now going to be sent to Slack with a message in this format. So I'll click save, and I can close the wizard. So notice I've not needed any transformation node in between these nodes. I can do the JSON mapping directly on these nodes now using the connected discovery wizard. So I can save this, and I can deploy the flow to the integration server. Let's create the message. So the message looks like this. So there's a root tag of issue, has a label, a title, and a description. And if I send that to my flow, then the issue has been created in GitHub and a Slack message is sent. So if I open my GitHub repo and refresh it, I can see that issue 35 has been created, which says need a fix for a problem. And if I open Slack, I can see it says new issue 35 has been created, and it has the application name and it has the flow name as well. So in this video, I've shown how JSON mapping can be done while configuring a discovery connector request node. You can access different parts of the message assembly and also access flow details while configuring the JSON mapping. This simplifies how you can do transformation when using the discovery connector nodes, and you'll notice that a transformation node was not required in the flow itself. So there's no need for a compute node or a mapping node. You can do the mapping directly of a node now in the connected discovery wizard.